What it do, homies? It's your boy Dave, and I'm back today. We back here on my NF journey. This time we checking out the song Wake Up. Let's go ahead, shut up and turn it up.
You spend your life in a dream that you can't escape. Cause you live your life in a coma, you never awake. If you'd open your eyes, then maybe you'd see what's at stake. You're sleeping. You're sleeping. You make a lot of money and you live in a mansion and pretty much got everything that you could ever imagine. But you feel like even though you got everything in the world, you got nothing. So what you do then is you start going backwards. You run in a direction and you looking for something that isn't real. And all you know is that you just gotta have it. What you doing is sleeping and thinking that you're awakening out. And the problem is that you don't know what you're after. So you put everything that you have into what you do, hoping that one day maybe you don't have to feel like you're empty. But as you get older, a lot of weight in your shoulders is getting heavy. Then you look back and you start to regret things. You only get one life, and every time you look into your, you feel like everything you have is a waste. And the problem and the reason you can never feel a hole in your life is because you were never awake. You spend your
life. Yo, let me tell you, for those who weren't in the know, this song could come as a wake-up call. A wake-up call. Now, he obviously isn't talking about simply being asleep. He's talking about those who are on autopilot, the type of people who are moving in life without some type of purpose or whatnot. So like he said, you just start pouring your efforts into something, hoping that maybe it will come later until you see somebody else coming by who looks like they have a purpose in life. And then you start regretting, right? These are the type of things that lead to a midlife crisis, you know, but he said you're asleep. You're just autopiloting through, hoping. And then before you know it, you know, you the age of 30, you the age of 60, not 30. I'm 31, so I don't want to say 30. I hope I got things figured out. You age of 60 and you wondering what happened, right? The time just feels like a blur. You just feel like you weren't doing anything. I had this somewhat of a feeling after I had kids, because I started thinking, what was I doing with my life? What was I doing with my time? Because now I have no time. You know what I mean? I get off my 9 to 5. I come here and I record my videos, and then I watch my daughter until 4 in the morning, and then I get up and I go to work. That's pretty much what my day consists of. I have very little time for myself outside of this. And you know, same thing, if I'm not careful, things are just going to fly by. You know, these last couple of years feels like a blur. Like, can we believe that COVID happened like back in 2020? But it feels like, if some of that feels like a blur, whole entire year just kind of feel like a blur. But it just sometimes we can go on autopilot and everything. We don't necessarily know what's going on until we wake up. But for most of us, that wake up doesn't happen until later on in life, right? This is a song NF telling us, you know, telling us, and of course it's about his journey and everything, is that be in the present, right? Be in the present, do things now. Don't wait and think that you might have it figured out. You know what I mean? So, okay, let's keep going.
For the hole in your life is because you were never awake. You spend your life in a dream. You can't escape. Cause you live your life in a coma, you never awake. Feel like you never got up and go to work, and you're feeling like you ain't got a purpose. And you're trying to get motivated, but everything you do turns into a mess, like you ain't nothing but worthless. And yo, you look around, a lot of these other people you looking at, to you, you describe as perfect. So you point a finger at God and tell him to do his job and fix your life up, cause nothing is working. And you would try to hide it and make it seem like it's nothing, but really you feel like everything is crashing around you. And you develop the problem in trusting in other people, which later became an issue that would mentally pound you. You only get one life, but every time you look into yours, you feel like all you ever see your mistakes. And the problem and the reason you can never move forward in life is because you were never awake. Wake up.
tell you something, bro. Oh, my goodness, man. Everything that NF's been saying has just been hitting me so hard, bro. This is why I decided to go down this journey. You know what I'm saying? And honestly, guys, the performance of these videos is kind of dropping. So I'm not sure if I'm, you guys are, yeah, this is why I kind of hesitated to reacting to every single thing down this journey, because I know it's not something that every single one of you will watch. Right. And of course, I would like for these to do well in views because, you know, I'm trying to grow a YouTube channel here. But it's almost getting to the point where some of these I might just want to watch off camera, you know. But anyways, besides the fact, my wake up moment came when I had my kid. Right. And I already told you guys, because I was thinking about what I was doing with my time. I wanted to show, well, first I wanted to show my kid that you can make something of yourself outside of a 9-to-5. You know, you can actually do something that you like to do and possibly make a career out of it. You know what I mean? But I'm pretty sure that, and this probably happens for most people who have kids, is that you do kind of slip into that coma. Right. And it's not that you shouldn't. It's just that when you have kids, for the most part, what you want to do and the bigger aspirations of your life need to get put on hold for your kids. You have to focus on giving them the life that you can never, you know, give yourself. But if you're not too careful, you might slip into something that's super comfortable. And by the time your kids are outside the house, you're gonna be like, yo, what happened? What's going on? Like, you can still pursue your dreams and take care of your kids at the same time. I do believe that it is extremely difficult. I tell you this most of the time when I'm recording these reactions, I am dead tired. And if you ain't realize it, that's because I really, really like music. Really like music almost to a fault and everything. But it just started hitting me. And I'm pretty sure it hits a lot of you guys when you think about the lyrics and how it reacts to your life, right? Are you awake? Was this your wake up call? Has there been something that you thought was going to happen later on in life, but then you realize, oh, I said that same stuff 10 years ago and now look where I'm at, right? You don't want to be in that spot. And a lot of us, we hear this over and over again. NF said it. There's a lot of people who got music stuff that's saying the same exact thing that NF is saying. And we hear it and we consume it, but we don't put it into action. This can be your wake up call, right? This is an amazing song. Listen to the message, consume what he is saying, and not just, wow, that was cool, and then go back to going back to sleep. You know what I mean? I mean, you gotta wake up. He's telling it to us plain and plain, like it can't get any clearer, honestly.
In your life, in a dream that you can't escape, cause you live your life in a coma, you never.
Look at that right there. See, I knew this was the route he was going. I knew it. And then all of a sudden you close your eyes and you wake up and then you're old, wondering what's going on. Now, he had a couple of symbolism going on in here as well, if that's the word. I think that's the proper word. She was underwater, right? So that suffocating effect. And I feel like when you're suffering from these effects, that it comes in three ways, actually. The third one is that you're aware, but you feel as though it's too late in life to do anything. So you continue to do nothing, right? The second one was absolute rage, right? Type of people that just goes out and starts taking their anger out on type of things, but don't necessarily know why, which explains kind of like the destruction that's going on around the house. And then the third being the suffocating feel, right? And then what that suffocation feel, what it tends to lead to is that you're going for something to give you you can't find the answer, so you go to like quick answers, right? And that's generally what leads to addictions and everything, because you're looking for a way to escape because you don't know what's going on. Some powerful stuff in here, man. But again, it's NF. What else is he gonna give us, man? I'm telling you, I'm enjoying this journey. Even if these videos don't perform well, I find myself wanting to take that next step in the NF journey and share my experience with you guys. I would like for them to perform well, but you know, We all got our likes and we all got our wants. But for those of you who's watching and stuck through my commentary, highly appreciate you. It's the end of this video. If you enjoyed the content, leave a like and subscribe. Dave's out.